A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th Feb, on the front page you have Supreme Court upholds changes to SCST atrocities law. So the Supreme Court has upheld 2018 amendments which barred persons accused of committing atrocities against those belonging to SCST from getting anticipatory bail. So the two judge bench as such held in their joint opinion that a high court would also have an inherent power to grant anticipatory bail in cases in which prima facie an offence under the anti-atrocities law is not made out. Means in general cases bail would not get, but in exceptional cases, so high court has the power, inherent power. Then here you have review court can refer questions to larger bench. So 9-judge Supreme Court bench has framed 7 questions on religious rights, and this we have discussed quite often earlier. But now the 9-judge bench has announced and has upheld that a review bench can refer a larger bench questions on the ambit and scope of a law. So the idea is that earlier Supreme Court rulings are that a review bench means a bench will give a judgment, and then if the judgment is reviewed, it asked for a review petition will be filed that reconsider the order. So this happened in the Sabrimala case. Sabrimala case, the Supreme Court has given its ruling in October 2018. And after that, we have seen that review petitions have been filed. So in this review petition hearing, what the Supreme Court did, it referred the question on religion to a larger bench, a 9-judge bench. So a 5-judge bench referred the case to a larger bench. So noted lawyer, Fali Nariman, he pointed out that this cannot be done because the Supreme Court ruling is that in review, question cannot be referred to a larger bench. So Supreme Court accepted that this is a valid point, you know, which has been pointed out. So now what they have done, the 9-judge bench has announced that this can be done from now on. A review bench can also refer questions to a larger bench. Then below you have Supreme Court seeks police review on Shaheen Bagh. So now Supreme Court has gently drawn attention of the citizens, mothers and senior citizens, about the agitation against the Citizenship Amendment Act and NRC. So this is causing inconvenience is because protesters are holding protests at public places, and this is going on for days. So what the Supreme Court is saying is that this cannot go on indefinitely in a common area. But Supreme Court, however, refused to pass any interim directions urgently in public interest litigation which was filed. So it was a PIL filed. Supreme Court made this observation regarding the protests in Shaheen Bagh, but that is it. So the court nudged the protesters about the bother created for ordinary commuters when protests were held on public roads indefinitely. And this is the Oscars which have been announced. Parasite, the movie made Oscar history by becoming the first non-English language film to win Best Picture at the 92nd Academy Awards. It's a South Korean movie. It also won in 3 other categories including Best Director. Then this is police register FIR in Gargi college molestation case. So Delhi police has registered an FIR against unknown persons on a complaint filed by the principal of Gargi college alleging molestation of college students by a group of men who had gate crashed a cultural festival on the premises. And students are staging protests on college premises over inaction. On page 7 you have BJP seeks honor for Savarkar to upset Mahavikas Aghadi, the coalition government in Maharashtra. So, to cause friction in the alliance, BJP has moved a proposal to introduce a resolution in the upcoming budget session in the State Assembly of Maharashtra that they want to honor Hindutva ideologue B.D. Savarkar with a Bharat Ratna. So, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, he was a revolutionary freedom fighter who was part of the secret organization called Abhinav Bharat, and he had right-wing ideology. So then on page 8 you have special category status not a closed chapter, says Jagan. So this is Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy. So earlier it was promised that special category status would be given to the states after AP was bifurcated into Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. But the central government, BJP government, refused to accept such a demand, and it is no longer discussed. But now the chief minister says that it may become a reality when center feels the need, and Andhra Pradesh may be given a special category status. Then this is four Indian pilots begin astronaut training in Russia. So one or two will be finally named for Gaganyaan mission, but four of them have begun training. As such, these are pilots who will be, are trained as astronauts in Russia. Then this is draft policy on rare diseases notified. So we had seen the draft policy, and now this policy has also been notified. It had been criticized because it was providing only one-time assistance for people with rare diseases. So this has now been notified as such. But High Court judges not satisfied the provision of 15 lakh for one-time treatment. So this was the case. The earlier policy as such provided for true assistance, but this one-time assistance will not be sufficient for rare disease cases, has been highlighted. On page 9 you have rioting students asked to clean up. So Madurai High Court bench judge ordered 28 students to sweep and mop hospital wards. This was a ruling given by Madurai High Court in this case of students who were rioting. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is reservation as a right. So this article, this editorial says that ensuring adequate representation to disadvantaged sections is a state obligation. So reservation has to be provided for SCs and STs for the adequate representation in education as well as in employment. So the legal position as such is not new. It says major judgments, including those of constitution benches, note that Article 16(4) on reservation in post is enabling in nature. So state is not bound to provide reservation, but if it does so, it must be in favor of sections that are backward and inadequately represented in service based on quantifiable data. So recently, the court, Uttarakhand High Court order was set aside as such, which and the Supreme Court ruled that it is not an obligation on the state to provide reservation. Then this is the second editorial. Then safeguarding the Delta. So this is regarding Kaveri Delta. This we saw in news yesterday, has been declared as a protected special agricultural zone. So this move for protected agricultural zone in Tamil Nadu favors food security over energy grid. So this cannot be used for mining and mineral exploration. So this. Then this is the lead article, liberty at the government's whim. So this is regarding Jammu and Kashmir High Court's recent ruling on preventive detention. So this stands as an antithesis of the constitution's basic function. So recently, Jammu and Kashmir High Court has ruled personal liberty, right to personal liberty is most precious right, but then it should be in accordance with the law and it cannot be denied except in accordance with the procedures established under the law. Means whatever the government establishes as a law, then under that right to personal liberty can be violated or can be taken away. So liberty at the whims of the government. So that is what the ruling is all about, is evident. Then this is a mix Indian healthcare can do without. So this is regarding Ayushman Bharat. So it entails diverting limited resources towards wasteful areas, ignoring productive fields in public health. So this talks about Ayushman Bharat scheme. So it provides health insurance as such, but it's also called National Health Protection Scheme. So it aims to provide insurance cover to nearly 50 crore poor Indians of around 5 lakh as such. So its precursor was Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana. So what has happened is, it says that recently 171 hospitals were reported to have been de-empaneled from the National Health Protection Scheme on charges of fraud. which also included issuance of fake e-cards and the manipulation of claims. So an FIR has also been registered, and because of such concerns being raised now, the Ayushman Bharat scheme will not be able to move forward. The fanfare which it was rolled out and the global hype it generated now has reduced to not any action on the ground. On op-ed page you have facing up to realities. So this is regarding health pandemics and economic crisis, like the new coronavirus. It cannot be masked for too long. So whether it's new coronavirus or economy under stress, so it cannot be hidden. And this is how India has responded in many ways to contain the epidemic of new coronavirus. And this is the calumny against Gandhi. So this article says that Mahatma Gandhi is not beyond criticism, but slander based on falsehoods amounts to vilification. It's highlighted. Like Pragya Singh Thakur praising Nathuram Godse as a patriot because he assassinated Mahatma Gandhi. So such statements being given. So if it's falsehood, then it amounts to vilification. That is it. On page 12, you have opposition walks out from houses over quota issue. So opposition parties have staged a walkout from both houses of parliament, and they have charged the center with failure to defend reservation in promotion. On page 13, you have don't make irrelevant submissions, Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has made it clear to mothers participating in the Shaheenbagh protest that it respects motherhood and social peace, but will not entertain guilt generating or irrelevant submissions about their children being called Pakistani terrorists or gaddars in schools. So CGI warned lawyers that irrelevant arguments and pleadings would be either cut short or struck off the record. So don't give such statements in courts, you know, that they are what, how their children are treated in school. But then it is a fact in some cases. And this is also child rights bodies directive draws flak. So this is National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, the directive which it gives seeking counseling for children at Shaheen Bagh. So this has been criticized as an attempt at stifling their voices. So this is what has been stated by educationists and researchers who visited the protest site. On international page you have World Health Organization warns of overseas virus spread. So cases outside China could be the tip of the iceberg, is what World Health Organization has warned. They have told if the new coronavirus has already reached 908. Then on business page you have chief of six banks under CBI ED scanner, finance minister. So no arrests have been made so far, but finance ministry has announced that chiefs of six banks have been under CBI and Enforcement Directorate scanner. So these are commercial banks, scheduled commercial banks. So details have not been provided, but now they are looking into cases of violation. It is actually under whistleblower's complaint that action is means taken, and an inquiry is being. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.